Now we're going to talk about the squeeze theorem. We've learned limit laws to tell us how to do specific limits, but what if we need to find a limit of a function that we don't know the law about? Well, the squeeze theorem is one way we can do that. So if we have this function g here that we care about, that we want to know its limit, but we happen to have a function h and a function f that we do know about, so that we know the limit as h as it gets close to a, and we know the limit of f as it gets close to a. And it happens that g is squeezed between f. So what do we mean by that? We mean that f is going to be less than or equal to g, which is less than or equal to h, near the point a that we care about. If we happen to have g squeezed between h and f, and we have that the limit as x goes to a of h of x is the same as the limit as x goes to a of f of x. So that means that both of these are going to the same point right here, approaching the same point. Then we can conclude that the function we care about, g of x, has the same limit as x goes to a because it's squished in between. Say we're trying to find the limit as x goes to 0 of x squared sine of 1 over x. Now we don't know how to do this because we don't know how to do sine of anything right now for limits. We don't have any limit laws for that. So what do we do? Well, we want to think about things that x squared sine of 1 over x might be trapped in between. And the sine part here, this is the problem. So what is sine trapped in between? Sine of 1 over x or sine of anything, what's the biggest sine can be? Well, the biggest it can be is 1, right? And what's the smallest sine can be? Negative 1. So if sine of 1 over x has to be between negative 1 and 1, then the function we care about, which is x squared sine of 1 over x, has got to be less than or equal to x squared and bigger than or equal to negative x squared. So what I've done here in this step is I've multiplied both sides by x squared. And I want to caution you that this works because x squared is positive. If you have something negative and you're multiplying through, that reverses these inequalities. So remember with your inequality rules, you have to if you multiply through by something positive, they stay the same. If it's negative, they reverse. And if you're not sure if it's positive or negative, you got to start doing cases, which is a pain. So anyway, we know though that our function that we care about, x squared sine of 1 over x, is between negative x squared and x squared. So that's the first step. We have something that's our function is being squeezed. But we have to know if these two functions we've picked on the edges are good enough. So we need to take the limits as x goes to 0 of x squared. And using our limit laws, that's the limit as x goes to 0 of x, the whole thing squared, which is 0 squared, which is 0, because the limit of the function x gives you back the number you put in. And if we do the same thing for the limit as x goes to 0 of negative x squared, first we can pull that constant out, negative 1 times the limit as x goes to 0 of x squared. And this limit we just found, so we know that's 0. So negative 1 times 0, which is also 0. So the important part here is that we found that the limit from above of the function that's bigger and the limit of the function that's smaller, here these are exactly the same. And what that means is, by the squeeze theorem, the limit we care about, the limit as x goes to a of x squared sine of 1 over x is also equal to 0, because it's squished in between x squared and negative x squared. Now, this is a kind of difficult concept here. It's really hard in general to come up with the right functions to squeeze your function in between. So here we're using negative x squared and x squared. And in general, it can be really difficult. But I'm going to give you some advice. There are certain functions that you, when you recognize those in a problem, you want to think squeeze theorem. So we know sine is trapped between 1 and negative 1, so we can always replace it with 1 and negative 1 and get bigger and smaller functions. The same thing is true for cosine. And another big one that you might not think of is arctangent. It's trapped between pi over 2 and negative pi over 2. So those are the big things you want to look for. That doesn't mean there can't be other functions that you're interested in. But, you know, make sure you keep these in mind when you're working with the squeeze theorem.